So starting off, I'm just going to put a white base down, and I'm using this NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Milk, and I'm just placing that on with a foundation brush. And a little tip that helped me was to just warm it up on the back of my hand before I put it straight on my face. That way, it blended a lot easier. Even though he's right beside you, when he says those words that hurt you, do you read the ones I also brought it down a little bit on my neck so that it looked a little more realistic, I guess. If what we had was real. Then I just went ahead and used my beauty blender to blend it out a little bit and make it look more realistic. Now I'm just using this liquid eyeliner and making some marks around my eyes so that it makes it look like a skull, you know? So just kind of see where I'm doing this. I'm kind of using my eyebrow as a guide and just making kind of like a oval circle kind of thing, you know? And forget about this stupid. So I totally forgot to set my face, but I'm just using the NYX pressed powder, and it's just a translucent powder. Now I'm just filling in the circles with this gel eyeliner, and just with like a flat brush, I'm just, you know, filling it in just like this. It hurts to know you're happy, yeah, it hurts that you moved on. It's hard to hear your name when I haven't seen you in so long. It's like we never happened, was it just a lie? Then I'm just going to go ahead and set that with a matte black eyeshadow. This will just set the eyeliner and not let it move anywhere, and it won't crease as much. Then I'm just taking this maroon colored lipstick and placing it on an angled brush, and I'm just doing some detail work here. So you can do anything you want. You can do polka dots or swirls, but I'm just doing like these half moon kind of shapes. It's more traditional, at least from the pictures I saw, to do it this way. And then I'm just filling it in with the lipstick again. Like the way it felt to fall asleep next to. Then once they're filled in, I'm just going to take this shimmery maroon color and just set it with that. Then I'm just applying the same lipstick that I use for my eyes and just putting it on there. And then I just took some black eyeshadow and put it in the center of my lips. Then I'm just contouring with the same black eyeshadow so that it looks kind of like I'm dead because I'm supposed to be like a skull, you know? Then I'm just taking the same gel eyeliner as before and just making a web on my forehead so you can kind of see how I did the design. It's really easy and simple. So I didn't really know what to do for this part, so I just created like this little triangle shape, but you can also do like a cross that would look really cool or anything else you want. So I lost the footage of where I did my nose and mouth, but that's probably the easiest part of this, so you can just kind of see how I did it from just looking at it. I just used the gel eyeliner and created the nose, and it did like little lines for my lips. So for my cheeks, I just did this little swirl design on both sides, and then I just put some little dots on it with my lipstick again. So then I just filled in the shapes I made on my chin. They're like lotus shapes, like the flower, and I just filled it in with different lipsticks I had laying around, like a red one, and then I used the same one I used on everything else on my face. So whatever you have laying around will work. Then I just decided to create some shadows in the spider web, so I just did that with some matte black shadow. So then I just created like this kind of paisley print on the side of my face. So as you can see, I don't even know what this thing is, but I just created it because I didn't know what else to do because everything else looked really hard. So this was like the easiest thing I could think of. And yeah, I just did the outlines and then again just filled it in with my lipsticks. But sadly, I lost the footage for that. Again, I was not having the best of luck with this video, but you'll be able to see it when I show you the final look. So now I'm just going to quickly show you how I made my flower crown. So the supplies that you will need will be some large fake flowers, a headband, and a glue gun. That's all you need. It's super easy. You probably already know how to do it, but decided to show you anyways. So just start by pulling off your flowers from the stems and then just start gluing them on. And I ended up using 5 of the flowers. I used 1 right in the middle of the headband and then I did 2 on either side of them, and that worked well. And yeah, that's all you do. And I think it's so cute. You can pick different colors, but I just chose to do like the whole burgundy kind of theme. So whatever you want. I just think it's so fun and I had a lot of fun doing this. Now I'm just gonna show you what it looks like all put together. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and let me know what you think about it in the comments. I know I'm not a professional artist, I definitely am not, so I just had a lot of fun doing it, so I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!